T-Walk, hit the battlefield and go berserk. 20-inch arms pumping iron till you know it hurt. He looking like he probably fresh out the pen, but nah, he just consistent, young and fresh out the gym. What's up, what's up, what's up? It's T-Walk Dog back here again with another video for y'all. It's hot outside, y'all see I got my shirt off. Just finished a good chest workout downstairs and was chilling out on the back porch. You know, feeling the breeze afterwards, just enjoying my day off. Ain't training no clients today. So I've been getting this question a lot on Instagram because lately, like I said, it's warm out. I've been posting videos. I mean, shooting, y'all see the jump shot? It's wet. Y'all see the bounce, y'all haven't seen me dunking. So people been asking me, why did you used to play basketball? Why did you stop? Pretty much, why don't you play basketball no more? Because they see, I got game, I got the handles, it's playoff season, like that. Yeah, so I just wanted to answer the question. So pretty much a quick background, I guess my athletic background. Before I got into fitness, before I got into this bodybuilding style of training, all I was doing was plyometrics. I was really into basketball, heavy. I was going to the NBA like every other kid. Got away from it. So, won state championship senior year in high school. Went to state's 11th grade year, but we lost. And we ended up beating that same team next year, smashing them. We ended up playing another team. Won championship. 17 years old in high school. Ball was light. Balling every day. Practice. Waking up 6 in the morning to go play pickup at the local middle school. Then, if it's summertime, going to play ball at the local playground. Practice, game the next day. So it was always summer league, everything like that. So ball was light, me and my crew. Shout out to y'all. You know, I miss playing ball. So to talk about, I guess, why I don't play no more, obviously, I'm 20, what, I turned 27 in a few weeks. I don't play ball no more. I got a job, I got a life, I'm training my clients, things like that. Obviously, I didn't make it to the NBA, so that didn't work out how I planned. But it's all good. I'm on the new things right now. Still gonna get my money up like an NBA player at one point. Just gonna keep grinding, keep hustling. But yeah, so pretty much, again, one state's dropped out of high school. If y'all don't know, one state championship, I ain't go back to high school. I was young and mature. But for me, school was never like the thing for me. I don't know. I didn't like to learn what they wanted me to learn. Now I'm educating myself, reading a lot of books. Financial education, if y'all read Rich Dad, Poor Dad, you know the person with the A's in high school don't always make the most money. So I'm going towards the Rich Dad route. That's my game plan in life. But yeah, so after one state, dropped out, played ball for a little bit, and also right before senior year in high school, broke my ankle, summer camp, first summer like tournament of the year, going into senior year, first play of the game, my boy shot the jump shot. I came in, if y'all know, I was a jumper, that was my thing. Very first play of the game, man. We drove like 3 hours away to this tournament, to this little camp. Very first play of the game, he shoots a jump shot. I come in, grab it on the put back dunk with the left hand, jumped over the dude, threw it in, came down, cracked my ankle, was out the whole summer. Went to the doctor, long story short. Doctor said, I hate to break it to you, T-Walk, but you gonna have to set out your own senior year. Me, my mindset, the way I am now with fitness was the same way I've always been. I've always been determined. I was crying for a few days because, like I said, ball was life since I was young. Now you're gonna tell me my senior year I can't play. So what I did was I made sure I played. I was rehabbing myself. I went to rehab for a few weeks and then I decided I was gonna do it myself. Long story short, whole senior year of basketball, I wrapped my ankle, I had an ankle brace. I found these metal prongs, I put them down the side of the ankle brace, strapped the ankle brace around it, then I took a headband and kind of double knotted it around the ankle brace, tied my shoes up, wore high top shoes, so my ankle caused me a lot of pain senior year. I had a better year my junior year. But yeah, long story short, still made it through, still played, still started. I was a small forward, had a jump shot, had bounce, but I didn't have bounce like I did 11th grade year before I broke my ankle, but still got a couple dunks in, things like that. But yeah, like I said, dropped out. Then I decided, you know, I still want to keep trying to do this basketball thing for a little bit. Looked at a couple schools, things like that. Then finally a school, local school I wanted to go to, went and tried out for them. They wrote me back, said they wanted me. But the only thing was I would have to redshirt for a year since I dropped out. So let me backtrack a little bit. After I dropped out, I got my GED right away. It was easy. I got like high scores on it, I guess, because most people that take their GED, they like drop out in middle school, so they don't have that high school education. Mind you, I went all the way through my senior year. I had the education. I just didn't really care to go to school, was sleeping in class. Had the flip phone, so it was easy to text. You could look right at the teacher and be like, yeah, but your hands be under the desk texting. It wasn't the touchscreen stuff. I don't think you could do that now. So I was never paying attention. But yeah, I got high scores on my GED. So long story short, again, the school wanted me, but they said you got a redshirt for a year at the time. I was broke. Family had that much money like that. Mom like, you know, you gotta get a job. So I'm like, yeah, I can't really afford to just go to school, chase this dream. I see all these people chasing it, they're failing. Years down the line, they ain't making no money. I'm like, let me get my money up, let me get my resume built up so in the future I can be good. Just kind of had to give up on it. So yeah, that's a brief summary of why I stopped playing basketball, a little bit of my athletic history. Like I said, I was a jumper. Wasn't too many people jumping with me. Wasn't too many people that could beat me in a dunk contest. And y'all know that. And right now, I can give me 2 weeks. At any point, if I wanted to train, like fly metrics, things like that, I could be right back to windmilling. I would come off, what is it, like 6 periods in high school? So say 6 period bell rang, however many periods it was, I go right to the gym, have my Nike boots on, jeans, and book bag on, just throw my book bag off, windmill it, no warm up with the boots on, pants, everything like that. Throw it off the wall. Everybody from school with me, y'all know that. Everybody from my town, y'all know. But this is for all y'all that are new. Might see my clips on Instagram, dunking things, they'll be like, damn, this man looked like he balled a little bit. What happened? So here's what happened. I don't want to make this video too long. Just wanted to answer y'all, all my supporters out there. Anything y'all want to know, let me know. I'll answer it. Hopefully, y'all subscribe to the channel. Like this video if you like this. If you want to see me talk about anything else, drop comments below. Make sure y'all get the new apparel. The link is in the description. TWalkTheHawkGear.com. If y'all need any plans, 12 weeks like a program, anything like that, link in the description, payhead.com/TWalkTheHawk. But otherwise, stay here, keep getting this free advice, these free workout routines, motivation, get to know me, whatever the case may be. And as always, do what you gotta do. Do what you gotta do, because it's that simple. TWalkTheHawk.